Firstly, let me apologize for the Minister of Trade and Industry, who's currently abroad. I had to come in as a deputy to give a talk and engage you as the sector. Firstly, I would like to acknowledge the MEC of Gauteng, MEC Mzwandile, the organizers of the South African Automotive Week. I think having just passed the exhibition, I am certain that a lot of work is happening in our country, and sometimes we are too hard to ourselves. And I know that some of those companies that I saw there would have come from abroad, but the fact that they can come here, it means there is an enabling environment in South Africa. I also want to acknowledge the representatives of the business sector that are here, representatives of labor, and any other distinguished guests that are here. On behalf of South African government, we are very much grateful to be here, in particular as the Department of Trade and Industry, and we must extend the message of gratitude for the invitation to be part of the 2014 South African Automotive Week. We think today is a crucial day, and we must use it to bridge the gap between all the important stakeholders. It's good that government is beginning to engage with the private sector in order to find solutions where there are still gaps on a number of issues. Now, what we want to make as an important point is that industrial strategy. So we thought that we must take an opportunity to engage with yourselves about some of the key policy proposals or some of the work that we are doing in order for us to see how far apart we are from each other in order to make a meaningful contribution. Now, what I will do, ladies and gentlemen, I will just make general remarks about the broad industrial strategy of South African government, as well as the growth trends that governs it. I'll also make a reflection on the state of the automotive sector globally and domestically, including the industrial support that we offer as government, because we think that this sector has got an important role to play towards the growth of the industry as it is. I want to take you back in the global financial crisis of 2008 that severely impacted on the manufacturing sector, broadly your sector, the automotive sector. The demand for automotive sector significantly contracted as a collapse of the financial systems meant that the individual and household had to reorganize their consumer priorities. And this was largely because of the aggregate household income that was affected as many people were losing their jobs. I think that's the point the MEC was making. As the global economic recovery was picking up in 2009 and beyond, the automotive sector registered a consistent trend of positive growth. This positive growth in global automotive industry has naturally had a positive spin-off of our local industries, and we have also seen the upswing in local demand for passenger vehicles. And this we'll have to acknowledge, because sometimes when certain things happen which are beyond our control, we're unable, when the economy is recovering, to make this particular point. However, the greater share of vehicle production globally is tilted in favor of China and other advanced economies. And this is reflected by a number of international companies that are in our shores here in South Africa. The share of Africa in general is very low, and we should begin a conversation on how best we can increase the aggregate share of the continent, in particular here in South Africa, in the overall global output of the sector. This means that as government, labor, and investors in the sector, we need to work together to improve our industrial capacity and use our competitive advantage as a country in order to increase our footprint in the global market. Since the beginning of the mandate of the fifth administration, we had made some few public pronouncements, and I think MEC might touch on those, about our commitment to radically restructure the South African economy. The central thrust to this radical restructuring is about organizing our economy in a manner that is, that promotes job, that creates wealth and redistributes it to the majority of our people, but more importantly, ensuring growth of our economy. This is about the systematic expansion of our industrial base through value addition, from which employment opportunities will be built and sustained, and in a sustainable economic growth that could be registered if that happens. The automotive industry is a crucial subsector of the manufacturing sector and therefore a central pillar of our reindustrialization program. At the heart of the reindustrialization strategy is the recognition that we need to diversify our industrial base and expand the local value chain in most of our industrial exports. This means that we need to process our industrial inputs locally and work towards export of locally processed products as value-added goods, as opposed to the raw materials. Because what would happen mainly in South Africa is that we have been exporting mainly raw materials. So what we are saying now is that there needs to be some level of value addition in the raw materials that we produce so that we can grow our economy. Recently, the department has launched the People's Career Automotive Incentive Scheme to resuscitate and deepen the manufacturing of mini buses as well as the MHCV segments. There continues to be a growing demand for other medium and heavy commercial vehicles in the areas such as infrastructure development, construction, mining and agriculture. So these represent the growing sectors, and we think that the private sector will have to take advantage of these growing sectors. As part of government support for industry, through the government preferential procurement policy framework, the state is committed to act as a market incubator for the earmarked industrial diversification and expansion of the manufacturing sector by purchasing particularly 80% local content in bus bodies. These include the state-owned entities as well as the metropolitan municipalities. As you know, that many of them are embarking in the BRT system, and there will be a lot of procurement in that particular space. In respect of what I've said above, the fact is that automotive industry is South Africa's leading industry. In 2013, the DTI introduced the Automotive Production Development Program. Two key objectives of the APD are to raise the production volume to what MEC was saying, up to about 1.2 million vehicles per annum by 2020, and substantially diversify and deepen the components supplier chain. The broader automotive industry is critical to the economy of our country and has been contributing between 6% and 7% of our GDP. The auto sector manufactured products contribute approximately 30% of SA economic total manufacturing output. 7 global light motor vehicle OEMs are located here, including, for instance, Ford, the Mercedes-Benz, the GM, General Motors, SA, the Nissan, Toyota, BMW, and VW. All several MHCV assemblers are also present, including the large multinationals like MAN, Tata, Scania, and so on. The assembly industry in South Africa is backed up by entrenched and growing supplier base, spreading across 4 major production hubs. Here where you are, Gauteng, Durban, and the surrounding East London and Port Elizabeth are the areas where there is concentration. The South African industry is building on the solid reputation of a producer of high quality comparative goods. Although it's still very small in terms of size, in terms of if you compare it with other producer nations by global standards, the sector in South Africa is increasing its rate of participation in global market. In 2013, total export increased by 8.2%, and this was the first time that the sector passed the 100 billion rand market in terms of export. So these are the issues that we'll have to raise to reflect how far the industry is continuing to make a contribution. Besides the sector-specific program of support, export growth in South Africa auto sector can also be attributed to the enabling trade policy regime, including the agreements such as in SADC, in the EU, the FTAs, as well as AGOA. The new developments that are expected to add more impetus are from, for instance, the finalization of the tripartite FTA in Africa, as well as the supporting of the manufacturing in the neighboring markets to increase opportunities for the component and sub-assembly packages. An example of this is the ongoing support of the development of the motor manufacturing base in Nigeria. South Africa was responsible for at least 72% of South Africa's new vehicles that were produced in 2013. Though in absolute terms, this sector is not yet considered a big global producer and was ranked 24 in respect of the total vehicle assembled, with the market share of at least 0.63%. South Africa's automotive industry recorded a trade deficit of 24 billion rand in 2013 as compared to 42 billion rand deficit in 2012. The primary reason for this is now that SARS has included transaction within the SACU countries in its formula of calculation. The Department of Trade and Industry remain committed in broadening the reach of its industrial policy levers to support automotive sector. Other assembly segments that are receiving increasing policy attention include those that are in the MHCV as well as the electric vehicles. On the MHCV front, the following have already been achieved. Firstly, the designated bus bodies for public procurement have already been achieved. The automotive investment scheme, including packages for the people's carrier, is now in place. The APDP production incentives to support the increased quantum of the component is already in place. Other areas of pertinent to the MHCV that are being investigated by the Department of Trade and Industry include the widening of support into agriculture or yellow metal and related segments. The incentivizing of higher levels of components manufacturing, including R&D support, so that the industry can make a contribution. Looking at widening the distribution and after-sales support in the regional markets. The electric and other green assembly possibilities are also being prepared for an ongoing policy, on an ongoing policy front. This is to ensure that South Africa does not become stuck as a producer of only high emission internal combustion type vehicles. All these policy initiatives, ladies and gentlemen, are being designed and implemented for the purpose of introducing significant mass scale of both assembly and component production. Yet these alone are not sufficient in ensuring growth in the fiercely competitive global environment, as presented by the two gentlemen before us. The fiscal support measures have to be complemented by ongoing value chain of upgrading upgrading efforts. To this extent, the launch of the implementation of the Automotive Supply Chain Competitive Initiative represents a collaborative industry accepted approach to issues affecting competitiveness in South African auto value chain. It is based on global best practice, and it is a good example for stakeholders working together for a betterment of value chain. As Ella referred to, the automotive production development is among the key fiscal support mechanism set out to assist autos in the auto industries. The APDP has four components of the industry support, which encourage high investment rate, incentivizing high volume of cars assembled locally to be sold in local market and for export, encouraging of local value addition through tax rebate as well as flattering of tariffs. Essentially, the APDP is among the various policy instruments that we as government are intending to use to stimulate local value addition and industrial growth in general. Similarly, the administration has undertaken to foster the development of the class of black industrialists. This will consist of financial support to emerging black industrialist enterprises, as well as the use of public procurement as a market for their product. In this context, This program is important for investors to note, especially even in the auto sector. This will allow the investors to access more government support earmarked for development of black industrialists, because we believe that partnership between the black industrialists that we seek to create and already existing industries will be important moving forward. I want to make reference to two important areas that we should all consider as we endeavor to improve the productivity of our automotive sector. In 2013, there was an extended period of labor unrest that affected productivity. Even though the overall growth picture was positive in the sector, however, the labor unrest did have a negative impact, and it slowed the growth rate. This is an important area of industry that should be considered. There is a need for a long-term arrangement of negotiations so that we can improve the wage structure in the industry in order to avoid frequent disruption that affects production in the main. This is because we need to achieve a long-term sustainable growth as a country, in particular in this particular industry, because we are all aware how critical role you are playing in ensuring stability in our economy. Lastly, as a country, we have comparative advantage on industrial output. Our global monopoly on minerals like platinum group that are central in the automotive production belt must be utilized to achieve the industrial expansion that we have been speaking about. The processing and value addition that we refer to must also consist of a deliberate investment effort to arrest our minerals inside the economy and export them as finished goods, especially in the auto sector. Would want to take this opportunity as the DTI and congratulate the organizers of this event, and we hope that through your deliberations, you will be in a position to assist government where there are policy gaps, to engage with yourselves so that we can make sure that working together, we move South Africa forward. Thank you very much.